Welcome to all as we join together this evening to celebrate Maundy Thursday, a special sacred event for Christians everywhere. Please take a moment to silence all mobile devices as we prepare for worship. Please stand and join me in the call to worship. What shall we offer for all God's goodness to us?
Thank you.
Please be seated. Let us pray. Holy God, source and sovereign, you put all power and authority into the hands of Christ, Christ who washes our feet in humble service. Teach us to love one another as Christ has loved us, so that everyone will know that we are his disciples. Through Jesus Christ, our teacher and Lord, we pray. Amen. As we approach a time of confession, let us recall the scriptural message found in Corinthians chapter 11, verses 28 to 32. The Apostle Paul wrote to the church at Corinth, "Examine yourselves, and only then eat of the bread and drink of the cup. For all who eat and drink without discerning the body eat and drink judgment against themselves. If we judged ourselves, we would not be judged. But when we are judged by the Lord, we receive discipline so that we may not be condemned along with the world. With confidence in God's abundant mercy, let us examine ourselves and confess our sin." Eternal God, who is never broken, we confess that we fail to fulfill your will. Though you have bound yourself to us, we will not bind ourselves to you. In Jesus Christ, you serve us freely, but we refuse your love and withhold ourselves from others. We do not love you fully or love one another as you command. In your mercy, forgive and cleanse us. Lead us once again to your table and unite us to Christ, who is the bread of life and the vine from which we grow in grace. Amen. After Jesus had washed the disciples' feet, he said to them, "Do you know what I have done to you? If I, your Lord and teacher, have washed your feet, you also ought to wash one another's feet. For I have set you an example that you should also do as I have done to you." Friends, hear and believe the good news of the gospel. In the name of Jesus Christ, you are forgiven.
Thank you. Friends, before we go into a time of prayer, one of the things that I want to make sure that I reminded folks, there is a Good Friday service offering tomorrow at 3:00. We will be having Stations of the Cross. It's all the Westwood clergy network together. So we'll start at the, I can't remember what side of the Methodist Church in the parking lot. Does anybody remember?
Irwin.
Yeah, what she said. Starts with a U. Erwanger?
Irwin.
Yes, exactly. So we'll be there if you want to come join us.
Or if you're from Kentucky, it's your wife.
What's that?
Your wife.
From Kentucky, yeah. Yeah, we have a hard time with syntax. So before we jump into prayer, one of the things that I wanted to share with y'all tonight, this is a season where we have come into traveling the Lenten journey. Being in a desert, asking some of those questions, who are we, even in the midst of all the layers and all the things that are kind of put on us in life. And we come to this moment of Holy Week, and it's a threshold time. It's kind of a culmination. And tonight, as we come to Maundy Thursday, as we talk about what Jesus is giving, his last words to his disciples, or as he says in that moment, I no longer call you disciples, but I call you friends. As he's talking to his friends, you're moving into a threshold time. And so before we read the scripture, I thought of this blessing. And it's from John O'Donohue. I'm not going to read all of it, but it's a blessing for the dying. It's actually a blessing that I read over my mom right before she passed away a few years ago. But there's one part in this that I think is true of us, metaphorically even, as we go through this season of entering into death. Because remember, we're part of the body of Christ, the essence of Christ that resides within us and all around us. And so we are walking with Jesus in our own lives, experiencing death and moving into a threshold time into resurrection, into new life. Thresholds are interesting places, right? It's kind of that step in between. And so hear this from John O'Donohue. May your heart be speechless at the sight of the truth of all belief had hoped. Your heart breathless in the light and lightness where each and everything is at last its true self. Within that serene belonging that dwells beside us on the other side of what we see. So friends, with that, join your hearts with mine as we pray. God, as we come into this time of prayer, as we have prayers and of people and of things and all sorts of different goings-ons within us and around us, those things that we can give voice to, we lift up to you now. And we pray that they can come out in whatever way they need to come out, for people, for things. But also for those prayers that are deep within us. Some prayers that we can't give words to, and that deepest prayer that we can never give words to, the prayer that you are praying for us, with us, calling us to move through the seasons of life, calling us to move through the Lenten journey towards a place of communion with one another and with the divine all around and within. And also moving us towards death. Death to all the things that have held us back from becoming our truest selves, image bearers of you, God. Truly human. We release those things. We empty ourselves so that your love, your presence, your compassion can fill us, even as you empty yourself into us. God, as we come into this time, we want to lift up those prayers, though, that we can bring to mind and bring to heart, out of heart. And so we want to lift up these folks or these situations to you now.
Alan.
Mackenzie and Brennan. God, thank you that you hear our prayers, and actually you are praying from our hearts with us these prayers. And we thank you for Jesus. We thank you that he came and he showed us what it means to be truly human. And we thank you for the words that he gave us when our words fail us, that we recite together now. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts, as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not to temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen. Our gospel lesson is from John 13, 31 through 35, the new commandment. When he had gone out, Jesus said, "Now the Son of Man has been glorified, and God has been glorified in him. If God has been glorified in him, God will also glorify him in himself and will glorify him at once. Little children, I am with you only a little longer. You will look for me, and as I said to the Jews, so now I say to you, where I am going, you cannot come. I give you a new commandment, that you love one another just as I have loved you. You also should love one another. By this, everyone will know that you are my disciples, if you have love for one another." Friends, this is the word of the Lord. So as we come into this moment of this Maundy Thursday, we've come to this part in our scripture and our journey, our Lenten journey that's now gone into Holy Week. And as we said last Sunday, the Lenten journey is an upward journey to Jerusalem, and now we're on the descent as we go towards tomorrow, Good Friday, and then to Easter on Sunday. But again, we're in this liminal space, this threshold time, and so we have these scriptures that as Jesus is with his disciples, his friends, they've gathered in the upper room there in Jerusalem to have their Last Supper. In that moment, Jesus does something amazing. You know, throughout his life, his ministry at least, what we know, he demonstrated this sense of service, of love, of compassion. Again, compassion, coming alongside somebody with passion or in their suffering, in their struggle. Jesus did that. He washed all the disciples' feet in that moment. And again, Palestine, the first century, still is a very dusty place. And they're walking around in sandals. And so it was a practice to wash feet. And here Jesus does that. Lowers himself, empties himself. And it's interesting. He washes everyone's feet, including Judas, the betrayer, signifying that all are included. No one is to be left out. When I was thinking about this, you know, this foot washing, it's powerful stuff. A few years ago, when I was on staff at Northminster Presbyterian, and we would take every 3 years a trip to Nicaragua on a service trip, a work trip. And in that time, I remember especially 1 week towards the end, we were going to do a foot washing. It had been a hard, hard week. You know, as you can imagine, when you have a bunch of folks together for a week, there is some conflict, different things. And yet, as we gather together, I remember at that camp that we were working at, our students here from Cincinnati, parents, other adult leaders, and then our Nicaraguan brothers and sisters. And we started doing that act of washing one another's feet. The tears began to flow. Folks began to hug each other. Forgetting and forgiving, well, maybe not forgetting, but forgiving some of the things of the past week that had caused conflict. And so we have this moment, and we come to even to this last passage after the foot washing and Jesus sharing. And again, within that, there's a great discourse there in the book of John, the farewell discourse, where Jesus is sharing all of these thoughts about, you know, I'm leaving, I'm preparing you, you're ready, your heart condition is good. You're living into love, and you're beating as one heart, and that's what I'm calling you to do out of that love. And he gives this great story in the last part of the passage. How will folks know that you're different? How will they know that something is emerging within you, that you're moving beyond the ego, if you will, to your true self? Well, how well you love, and how well you love out of your heart. Not for anything that it gives you, but for what you've been receiving from God and giving out to the world, from the divine that resides within you. How well we love, how we experience love. Often we think that it's about believing the right stuff, having the right doctrine or whatever, or about numbers or winning some argument. No. It's how well we love. And again, the phrase that I like, and you've heard me say it, it's better to be connected than correct, right? It's better to be in communion and experiencing that love and giving that love. The very meaning of the word Maundy comes from the Latin word in which we get the word mandate. Jesus is giving us a new mandate, a new commandment, if you will. That we love one another authentically. Now, in some church traditions on this night, we would have a stripping of the altar, take everything off at some point during the service. That tradition symbolizes Christ's humility. Humility literally also means being of the earth. All of us are connected. Take a moment. Feel your fingers. Just go ahead and do it. This is organic stuff. This is of the earth. The same organic material in the trees, in the animals. We're all connected. And what Jesus is doing is saying humility is about getting in to the root with one another. And remembering, as we talked about at the beginning of this Lenten journey, that we are dust, stardust. And we've been formed, and there's a spark within us, a God spark, God's presence living within these jars of clay. We are image bearers of the divine, of God. And this is a God who says, I make residence within you, within this organic material that I created. And we're all connected. Some other thoughts. Jesus didn't come as an earthly royal, but he came to us humbly and gave us everything, emptied himself into us. And tomorrow, as we celebrate Good Friday, the day that we've chosen to commemorate that, we know that Jesus goes to the grave. And then we have an even deeper liminal space of Saturday, that in-between time. What do? But then we come to resurrection. Something more powerful than any earthly symbol can really even demonstrate. And that's love. So tonight here, in a moment, we're celebrating the Lord's Supper, remembering, as Jesus told us on that night a couple of thousand years ago, that we, all of us here, are his body. in a particular part of the body called Westwood First Presbyterian, in a particular neighborhood. Reminding us that we are the body of Christ, that we are broken by all the things that break the heart of God. And that through Christ, God's life is being poured out for all of us through Jesus, giving us life. Friends, God is our life. At our core, again, remember, we are image bearers of God. And we are called to be his hands and feet together in this world, a world desperate for love, for compassion, for grace. And tonight, we join with billions of people around the world from every background, celebrating our unity in Christ's love, in Christ's presence. And remember this, you've heard me say this, in our Presbyterian understanding, we have this word that we like a lot. It's called one. We have one communion, the communion that happened on Maundy, Thursday, and we're just remembering it. We're still living in that communion. And that communion is with all people, with God, with all creation. That's a powerful statement when you think about it. It means that we've got to show up for folks around us. Show up for the world. One communion. One baptism. Again, one. Jesus' baptism for all of humanity. And we participate in that. That's one of the reasons why we say we have an open table in the Presbyterian Church, because Christ's baptism is for the world. One God, one faith, one humanity. Friends, we are one. Yes, we have lots of different thoughts, lots of different opinions, lots of different personalities, but our hearts are the same. God's heart, our heart, beating together. And so as we come to communion in a moment, remember that Jesus, we're participating in that communion. We're participating in that moment, remembering, but also we're there too, and being reminded of Jesus' words, love one another.
Friends, again, as we come into this time, into this space, remembering that this is an open table, that this is the table that Jesus laid out for us, all are welcome. Please come to this table. Join your hearts with mine as we pray. God, as we come into this time, we remember what that word communion means, coming together in union, knowing that as we come to this moment, that we've had all sorts of things happen throughout our days, and throughout today even. And yet, as we come into this time, may we remember that we can let go and empty ourselves and come to this table knowing that it is a table of grace, of forgiveness, of love, of the power of emptying oneself into you, even as you empty yourself into us, remembering that in our Trinitarian understanding that God the Father empties into God the Son, and God the Son empties into the Holy Spirit, and the Holy Spirit then also empties in that circular cycle, and that you have invited us into that Trinitarian flow, emptying into us and giving us the opportunity to empty into the world around us. God, we thank you for this moment of communion. We thank you of remembering those words that you gave us in your farewell discourse 2,000 years ago, that we still live into those words, into that presence 2,000 years later. And so, God, we thank you for this moment that we can remember. We thank you for this moment that we can be reminded that we are the body of Christ. And we thank you for this particular body tonight here at Westwood First. We pray a blessing upon all these elements. In your name, amen. Friends, please join me in the celebration of the Lord's Supper. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. Friends, on the night that Jesus was betrayed, he took bread, common bread, and he broke it. And he said, "This is my body, broken for you. When you eat this, remember me, and also remember who you are as my body." In a similar way, he took wine, or in this case, grape juice, and he poured it out from common grape. And he said, "This is my blood, being shed for you, being poured into you." Remembering that God is emptying God's self, Jesus emptying himself into us. Reminding us that he is filling us and asking us as we are being emptied and filled to share this love, this life with the world around us. Friends, these are the gifts of God for the people of God. And now I'd like to call a server forward. We also have a gluten-free option, so we will have that. On this side. Come forward, please. Friends, let's pray. God, we thank you for this moment, again, reminding us that we are in communion with you, that your presence transcends time, space, boundaries, that we are present with you as you are present with us. You even reside within us. God, as we come into this time and we remember your death, and we go through the stations tomorrow and think about that and ponder on that, and as we go through the in-between time of Saturday and then coming back and celebrating resurrection, God, may we continue to grow into our understanding of what it means to be image bearers of you, to be truly human, to follow in the way of Jesus, to live in the presence of Christ. We thank you for these gifts. We thank you for communion. We thank you for all that you're doing in and through this congregation. And again, we pray a blessing upon this moment. In your name, amen.
Thank you. sometimes it causes me to it calls.